I live in the middle of nowhere, on unpronounceable street on the first floor. There's only one floor. My name is Sseth Tzeentach. I'm 27 years old. I believe in taking care of myself in a balanced diet and a rigorous exercise routine. In the morning, if my hands aren't shaking, I'll take 360 milligrams of extended release amphetamine while doing my daily jelk session. I can do 1,000 now. After I start to feel heart palpitations, I go to the vitamin closet. For multivitamins, I take 2 gummy dinosaurs, then a gummy fruit pastel and a single magic bean. Then I chug down 2 gram paracetamol to slow the approaching migraine while I prepare the rest of my routine. I always use a painkiller with little or no risk of stomach ulceration because stomach ulcers are incredibly painful and make you die. Then 2 tabs of zinc, then omega-3, followed by a final mega dose of vitamin D3. There's an idea of a Sseth Tzeentach, some kind of abstraction, but there is no real me, only an entity, something illusory. And though I can hide my cold gaze, and you can shake my hand and feel flesh gripping yours, and maybe you can even sense our lifestyles are probably comparable, I simply am not there. In case you haven't figured it out, you can't mix races. You get so mad so fast. You're training years in just days. You're learning forms of anger that take decades to develop. The Lord, he simply watches as I trip myself repeatedly and blame everybody else. And I'm an empath, which means even if I'm not a brat fag, I have walked that path and I have found it to be morally dubious. Inflation? Don't worry about it. Take more loans, print more money. Fellas, I gotta confess, I'm down bad. I got caught peeing in the sink. Now, I don't think that's weird. It's a victimless crime, just like punching someone in the dark. If the sink is so forbidden to urination, then why is it placed so perfectly, reducing my hesitation? But I feel embarrassed. No, not because I did it, but because I got caught. I'm not gonna stop. I'll just get better. For the future, I'm gonna trick shot my stream around the sink bowl. That's a silent projectile. Effectively, I'm applying a suppressor to my gun barrel. That way, members of my family cannot ambush me so easily, and I will not be shamed by people who immediately revert to authoritarian fascist statements such as, "We have 2 toilets. Why did you use the sink?" Listen, I saved water. I saved lives. Maybe a few decades from now, there'd be entire villages in sub-Saharan Africa singing songs of praise over how much water I saved. And you know what? All I had to do was unload my fire hose in a kitchen sink. Dog butthole. Notice, standard for vehicles of its time, the traditional German Achegau paint job. Eventually, I was left with nothing. Just me and a small bag of crack. I knew I had to get my life together. So, I smoked the whole bag. If you're slow and decrepit and past your prime, which, for a man, is about 14 years of age, being born with a baby arm. You're born and one arm develops normally into an adult arm, but the other is this stunted mini child arm, which stops growing at like 3 years of age. So you're this freakish monstrosity. You'll be known around town as Baby Arm Man. And the only job you'll ever have is baby arm stock photo. Because it's harder for them to get a kid to pose for that. It's a lot more convenient to have a malformed monstrosity on standby. Putting my trust in a random Polish stranger gives me better results. And egg can make a cow forcibly pregnant. Not really much more to say about that. We know the rest. The milk industry, reptile eggs. For every dollar you spend, I will personally steal a liter of clean drinking water from the children that need it most. Forget charities that make things better. I promise I'll make them worse. Because ultimately, there's only one way to win war. Blood. A lot of blood. Money is merely the vehicle to convince you. We just need you to die. Am I allowed to say this? A crack pipe. Everything you need to do a little magic. It's an intentional form of torture. Everything you gain is outweighed by everything you lose. Namely, the ability to close your eyes ever again without that image burned into your skull. And we both know exactly what I'm talking about.
Hello, guys.
Robbing an ATM at 2 in the morning. At which point, I start to mock them. I call them gay and immediately apologize, unless they identify with that label. In which case, I send a little kiss, you know, to establish dominance. Are you a child? I hope not. How did you end up here? Did your mother leave you alone with a tablet, assuming that the cold hard expanse of the internet is somehow an appropriate surrogate to parental attention? In which case, I'm incredibly sorry. I'm sure your parents will take full personal accountability for your impending developmental issues. That's right, you're going to be kissed to death by a pack of nanny dogs who just broke out of the local nursery. And guess what? Breakfast was free infants ago. You're the main course. Think about that next time you're engorging yourself. I believe Central Intelligence can employ this in the future. We join someone's game, forcibly download illegal content to their PC, and do a sting operation on their residence. If they start screaming civil liberties or probable cause, cite Penal Code 129, paragraph 27, subsection C, which states, anyone caught playing Hearts of Iron 4, Europa Universalis, or Company of Heroes 2 is probably a domestic terrorist. This is a similar experience to visiting grandma. The longer you stay, the higher your risk of cardiac arrest. She won't kill you out of hatred. She'll drown you in the pancake syrup river of love. Just like a doctor only treats the sick so he can beat the ever-living shit out of them himself. They came for the furry inflationists, and I did not speak out, for I was not a furry inflationist. And then they came for me, and there was no one left to speak out. But if you want a more fitting title, it's Harry Potter and the Yugoslavic War Tribunal. Yes, it's a fantasy military campaign. And you know what? It still runs on corn. Get me? That one in a million mythical thyroid that shoots out thyroxine so fast, you're gonna live at like 2x playback speed until your heart explodes. Not like I care. I got a replacement waiting. It's inside somebody else. You'll get somebody talking shit about how great their processor is just because Rakesh at the Dell store told them so. Necromancy. They're trying to bring back the good old days by raising them from the dead. And I'm currently competing for kidneys with my arch nemesis, who is, of course, a dog. So I don't really know where to take this metaphor. The manifestation of death is outside our door. And he's fucking up our corn. World War II. A fictional war where Germany hired Hugo Boss to design their fashionable blitz of Europe, Russia managed to kill 24 million of their own people, and the US greatly increased the temperature of two neighborhoods in Southeast Asia. Forget those two archers in Anne Orlando. That will seem like a pleasant memory when you're getting stunlocked by roast turkey. Sunset found her squatting in the grass, groaning. Every stool was looser than the one before and smelled fouler. By the time the moon came up, she was shitting brown water. The more she drank, the more she shat. But the more she shat, the thirstier she grew. And her fur sent her crawling to the stream to suck up more water. I rest my case. J.R.R. Martin is the greatest author who has ever lived. So please join me in prayer. Lord in heaven, please grant everyone online a present father figure in their lives so they can stop writing they cringe-ass comments and making they cringe-ass react videos. But the taller you stand, the harder you fall. And one day, it's all gonna come crashing down. You're gonna lose your money, you're gonna lose your life, and when you're dead, they're gonna chop you up and sell your pieces. Imagine releasing the ancient game of Mahjong as a standalone product today. It would play for you automatically until you reach a perfect 50-50 win-loss ratio, regardless of your own skill. It would have gacha mechanics. They would be described as forgiving, reasonable, and I'm paid to write this article, where 10,000 pulls grants you a single pity pull, where you can take out a loan at the press of a button to buy more gacha. And that little twig you throw is a DLC sold separately. Until one day he said he wanted to VC, and I said no, you can't. Your kind doesn't have that capability. Well, now I feel stupid and he thinks I'm racist. Apologies for the delays. I've been busy bone mashing for the past few weeks. Look it up. I really don't think I need to explain myself. And Earth Magic is basically just talk shit, get buried alive. I love simping for corporations. I love cash shops. I love that yummy high fructose corn syrup. I love the United Nations. I saw some fucked up shit and popped my eyes. I need a replacement. I am currently depressed. I need a new brain. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the former patriarch of a Rothschild family who received 9 heart transplants during his life really cared to make sure that every single one of them were ethically sourced from the nearest Malaysian child. You can't be bad at video games, as video games are merely a subject matter. No, that is a deficit in your cognitive ability, something that likely plagues you in every aspect of your life. If you a Latin American or Middle Eastern militia looking to expand your services, hit me up. 45 second integration doesn't sound like much, but I assure you, that's a lot of stolen AMV footage that I can crossfade into footage of your men wearing turbans. I can also do a full dedicated video where I can quickly summarize the fine points of your proposed benevolent regime, namely, the peaceful transition of power. As Sun Tzu famously said, when two men sword fight in the shower, the winner strikes first. Positives? Destruction of humanity. Negatives? He's going to kill us all in the process. All in all, a mixed bag. So we can kill them with a tumor instead. Maybe. We should have never dropped those bombs to begin with. It's a great form of population control. I found out that men in this game are categorized as a humanoid, whereas women fall under the category of creature. People who believe that flying is real. Which, by the way, there's no such thing. You're telling me that if you drive this car fast enough, it's gonna go up in the air and soar like a bird. Okay, sure thing, buddy. They literally put a scrolling wallpaper and rock the cabin and have you pretend you just moved across the world. Here's an idea. Next time you're in the middle of your flight, try to stand up and leave. Tell the flight attendant that you're pretty happy where you are and you would just like to get off. So if you don't mind, please stop the plane and let me get out. You'll notice them start to visibly shake, sweat, and foam at the mouth at the suggestion, giving you all manner of excuses as to why that's not possible. What's it called when you ask for something? Suggestion. What's it called when you ask for something while pointing a gun at their head? Persuasion. Imagine a teenage girl whose bloodstream is nothing but cocaine and benzos, armed with a single corporate credit card which has an overdraft of 700 trillion. This is your competition. I don't remember which war Granddad was fighting, but I do know Patches. I know that, canonically, he is circumcised. This is the end of good videos. Here on out, there are no good videos. I'm tired of living in fear of some commenter coming at me saying, Sseth, you actually made a factual error. Correct. I did. And I'll do it again. Shoot a plane, you miss. Shoot the open air, you get a kill. I check the scoreboard, and it's for a player who hasn't even spawned. Race war now. Kill every human that ever lived. Swapping two units inside a cloud of gamer girl miasma makes them gag all over again. Forever, until their nostrils bleed and their organs collapse out of mercy to escape this mustard hell. The only real way forward is understanding stem cell differentiation to grow your own tissue that will not be rejected. Now, I've been thinking of branching out into the financial sector and opening up a sperm bank. But to do that, I need a lot of money. Advertiser money. First 50 to invade get a 15% off their first month of thughunters.com, the official sponsor of this video. Is there a reward at the end? A little tangible reward for my simplified Coomer erectus brain? No. Would you be interested in resurrecting a dead god and ending life in this universe as we know it? Please let me know. I can't pay very much. Necromancy work is not unionized. It's been a subject of union busting for years now. The Federal Reserve is run by hyperinflation fetishists. But here's the thing. They're not doing it for money. They're doing it because they're perverts, and they find it to be extremely, extremely hot. A truly tolerant society should not tolerate the British. And if you actually dare to spawn in as one of your shitty little Wright brother origami paper planes, you will have a very short but very memorable experience. Just because somebody chose to take a smaller shit in my rice doesn't change the fact that it's still there. Inside my bowl, steaming up my Tupperware. Most 88mm shells are made in June, making them a cancer, while most of the bulk production of German armor was late September, making it a Libra. Cancer typically defeats Libra, unless Mercury is in retrograde, in which case, all bets are off. I don't have a fitting modern word for this, so I asked everybody younger for an appropriate expression I could use to convey my enthusiasm for the music. Here goes. It's bussin'. I recommend gaslighting family members into giving you money, blackmailing relatives, or petty crime. Remember, always under 1,000. That's the threshold for felonies. Gotta keep that record squeaky clean. Hey, have you ever been audited by the tax man? Let me tell you, it's a lot of fun. Sometimes, the only option you have to preserve the purity of your experience is brain damage. Disclaimer, I am in no way affiliated with the Chinese tar factories that make these. That would be lame. Everybody hooked on Xanax? Yeah. Lamau. Lol even. My sincerest condolences, you are screwed. The bards of yesterday are pretty much the SoundCloud rappers of today. Ritalin is a vampire, and it's gonna suck your will to live. It's gonna try and remind you every day You're nothing without it. And believe me, not a single day has passed where I did not consider going back. But after so long, I finally realized I'm not sick. I was never sick. I just live in a sick society where someone's individual worth is measured only by the raw productive output they can spit out before being chewed up by the gears, irrespective of their own unique neurochemistry and spirit. Fuck being valuable. It's not for me. It's never been for me. It's for sustaining some misery machine. I'm sorry I never read the fine print of my birth, but I never signed up for this. Feature lyrics by XXXTentacion, which would be fitting, because, you know, they're undead. And he is, similar. I knew that being gay is going to be an uphill battle, and to this day, I'm still losing. This game taught me that any amount of xenophobia and racial hatred can be overcome by, building walls. I guess it makes sense. They don't have to see me, and, I don't have to see them. Let me tell you how I got here. I still remember the exact moment I broke. It was when I saw a particular GIF of, She-Hulk attorney at law twerking. That's when I broke. That's when I said, fuck it, I'm done. Nothing matters. I'm selling out. Four dudes hiding behind a cow isn't great, but it's better than getting capped in the middle of the street. You don't know how short your life is. Imagine seeing something pouring from the sky, and it's either gonna kill you or make you pregnant. That's quite terrifying. True story. Once upon a time, Miyazaki's car broke down in the middle of a road. This was during winter, so no help was to be found. When suddenly, three strangers appeared out of nowhere, sucked him off, and left without even saying a word. Homo Soveticus. Our men leave their homes with teary eyes, domestically abusing their wife one last time because they know full well they might not come back. I've been listening to alpha podcasts, and according to men talking to other men, women desire nothing more than a man that looks like Australopithecus. That's the ADHD experience of life every day. Wake up, scream, and die. Imagine, for example, you're under police interrogation and they show you a 4-pixel image and ask you, what do you think about that, huh? And naturally, you respond with, I guess it's all right. Oh yeah? Well, they zoom out the image, and it's a still frame picture of one man, naked, about to descend his entire weight upon an empty glass jar. You're a real sick puppy, you know that? And just like that, you become a deviant to society. You're locked up forever in fetish jail. Most don't even last the winter before getting vored by pyro. Anyway, I forgot the point I was trying to make. Let's proceed. Because we've never owned slaves. I actually asked my relatives, and technically, what we had would be referred to as serfs, and turning him into a flesh painting that cannot die. That's a good ending, by the way. While ADHD medication is very useful to satisfy expectation and fit into the psychopathic mold of society, after 7 years of regular consumption, it's good to take a break. Unfortunately, my internet provider and the people who work there are the product of a brother and sister who loved each other a little too much. Just because I'm offered the ability to talk to a woman doesn't mean I'm going to take it. Just like Super Mario 64 was originally going to release with pregnancy mode enabled, at the end of the day, it's a limitation of the engine. Imagine you're an explorer, and you stumble upon this isolated village inside the Amazon, consisting entirely of Crystal the Fox, but there's no males, so you gotta do your part. You gotta turn those woodland creatures into woodland Twinkies. A tank shell can transform brick walls into brick memories. And to the person who inflicted this upon me after a 4-hour game, I wish you a very pleasant retrograde ejaculation. I've seen a lot of erotic illustrations of Blunarius, porn, if you will, and it makes me act up. I'm highly emotional and unstable, so yes, this will affect my opinion. And much like an abusive stepfather, let's just say a little bit of War Thunder will always be with me, whether I like it or not. My life is currently one of those Fortnite shirts you see around town, except instead it says, eat, sleep, scream, repeat. I fucking hate this. Never ask a woman her age, a man his salary, and Ninja Kiwi how they recorded their Moab popping sound. Oh nine, Entschuldigung, we have not escalated the battle phase. Please continue losing a little longer before we can authorize the countermeasure.
for what you're currently losing to.
Gaslighting? Gaslighting isn't real. You're just crazy. Now, take your medication. You want something done? Stop recruiting on LinkedIn. Go to Fur Affinity instead. My sources are some schizophrenic guy whose bathroom was red with chicken blood. And before you say, Sseth, I don't think he sounds reliable, I'll have you know, he's a practicing doctor. Every blood moon we have to offer the vitae of a child to Mr. Beast. Spike Factory keeps out the homeless. Get that fong out yo boosy, playa. This is a game where the phrase recruit the hoes is an entirely valid and effective strategy. A famous YouTuber once told me while driving past the local kindergarten. Early access. First, let's talk about the bad guys. The British. I'm kidding. The orcs. I don't know exactly what I'm looking at. Could it be a nipple? Maybe. I'm a wanted war criminal. Like Icarus, I flew too close to the sun. Or in this case, I flew too close to one chicken dinner too many. For any civilization, several generations of high infant mortality, and we're on the brink of extinction. But I digress. As my good friend Mandalore Gaming often says, can we stop discussing children without the muzzle of quality control? I can flow more freely, like a sewage drain. I would describe the experience like using the devil trigger from Devil May Cry. I used high gasoline prices to in turn buy more crack, which I used to call fueling my addiction. I know, I'll spend my entire life online and become increasingly weird and isolated, divorced from reality. Self-esteem? What's that? In conclusion, I forgot the point I was trying to make. Get your car and go buy a 40-pound bag of rice. Trust me, you'll thank me later.